Good morning, students. How are you? This is the 8th video of the chapter Socialism in Europe and Russian Revolution. And in this chapter, we discussed many points about the socialist and about the Russian Empire. We already discussed that Russia was under the control of Tsar Nicholas and his economic structure and the social condition was not favorable to him. That is why every time the people were doing revolt against him. Like we saw that in 1905, workers came against him. Again, we saw that in 1914, during the First World War, he was held responsible for the war, for the loss of his army, for the defeat of his soldiers. And ultimately, people started hating him. Now, in this video, we are going to discuss about 1917. So, what was specific about the 1917 and particularly the month of February? So, what was there in the month of February? We'll have to understand after discussing this topic. Now, here it is written, the February Revolution in Petrograd in 1917. We all know that Petrograd was the new name that was given there by Russians. And you'll have to understand that what was the condition there. One important river was flowing. The river was Neva. And what was specific about the Neva? That on its left and right bank, different type of structure was created. I mean to say, that on the right hand side, on the right bank, workers were there, factories were there, and on the left side, the Winter Palace was there, special government buildings were there. So this is how that categorization was done by the river Neva. So people were scattered on the left and right bank of the river Neva. So that is why this river Neva was very important. Because it created division among the different groups. Now, I am going to tell you specifically about the 22nd of February. One incident happened on that particular day and it created a widespread impact in Russia. So let me discuss what was the incident that took place on that particular day. On 22nd of February 1917, lockout took place in one factory. And as a result, the workers came on the street because no job was there. Workers were fired from the job. But in sympathy, 50 factories in Russia, they supported the workers who were expelled from their job because of lockout. And as a result, they came on the street. So the whole street of Petrograd was full of workers. Workers were coming from all the 50 factories to support the workers who were expelled from the factories, who was locked up. So this created a widespread tension among the Tsar, among his regime, because now workers were on the street. They were protesting against the Tsar Nicholas. And Tsar Nicholas was already frustrated because of the previous conditions. In 1905, he saw that how the workers created deep impact there. And again, in 1914, during World War I, he saw that tension. So another tension was waiting for him. And it came in the month of February in 1970. So that was the specific year and specific month that created much tension and at last tension for the Tsar Nicholas. Now here 50 factories, workers came on the street and government took also its own step to stop it. So government imposed curfew so that people should not go to the Winter Palace. They should not encircle the government buildings to protest against the government. But it was a very difficult task. Curfew was imposed. The mob was dispersed. But again, they came back. Again, they came back on 24th, 25th. And again, cavalry was called by the government to disperse them. So it was going on. Situation was very tensed from both the sides. Now finally, the cavalry came. Finally, the cavalry came. The next time also, on 25th of February, after that, cavalry again was called in by the government to stop the demonstrators. But this time, cavalry refused because they were knowing that the king is already weak. So, cavalry refused because they were knowing that we are going to kill the Russians. So, that is how, that is the reason why the cavalry stopped, why the cavalry refused. And it was a very surprising event that took place at the time. The soldiers, those who were part of cavalry and other soldiers also, they joined the workers, the strikers, those who were on the strike. And workers and the soldiers came together. They joined together. They joined hand together. And thereafter they formed a new council that was termed as Soviet. So Soviet was formed in the country. And after that, it was a very dangerous situation for the king, Tsar Nicholas, because now the soldiers were on the side of workers. The same soldiers whom he sent to suppress, now the soldiers were on the side of workers, and they formed a group also that was termed as Soviet Petrograd. So this created tension among the nobility and particularly in the mind of Tsar Nicholas. Many delegates went to meet Tsar Nicholas, and he was convinced that he should fled away from the country. He should leave the throne, otherwise he will be killed. So he was a very clever man. He was a very smart man. He took the decision, he took the suggestion very seriously, and he abdicated his throne. So this is how, due to February Revolution, monarchy ended. So this was the specific thing about the February Revolution, because it created abdication of throne and it ended the monarchy in the country. Now, after that, the Duma that was already suspended by Tsar Nicholas, all the members of the Duma came and supported the Soviet. They appreciated the work of Soviet because they were also very frustrated with the King Tsar Nicholas. And here we can see that all the members of the Duma plus all the members of the Soviet, they came together, again they joined together, and they formed a government that was termed as provisional government. Provisional means temporary government. So we can easily see that temporary government was formed or provisional government was formed by coming of Soviet and Duma together. So we found already that in the Soviet, who was there? In the Soviet, workers were there, plus soldiers were there, and here in the Duma, middle class was there, some members of aristocrats were also there. So all together we found that industrialists, aristocrats, middle class, workers and soldiers, they formed a group, and this group was now ruling the country. It got the chance to rule the country, and that type of government was termed as provisional government. It was not the fixed government, it was not the permanent government, but by that time, it was a government that was required at the time. Later on, the provisional government also felt that we should go with the election, we should promote the universal adult franchising. So they supported the idea of universal adult franchising, and they decided to go with election system. So in the upcoming topic, we will discuss about the universal franchising, and we will also discuss that what led to the emergence of socialist group there. Because here up to this, no socialist group is there. No socialist group has emerged up to the February 1970. So we will discuss that how the socialist group came and how they took over the provisional government. So here we can say from the monarchy Tsar Nicholas, we can see Soviet, from Soviet provisional government, and from the provisional government we'll see how the socialist government is going to be formed. So there is a complete chain. You can see the chain from Tsar Nicholas towards Soviet, towards provisional government, and from provisional government towards socialist government. So we'll discuss in the next video. Thank you.